Rose?
Yes.
I'm WPC Page. This is PC McCann. He's in the basement.
The ambulance men are with him. That's where he lives. Me and Mr. Morris found him.
What time is this?
About half an hour ago.
There's nothing we can do, I'm afraid.
Oh, no.
I could have told you that the way he was lying there.
Do you want us to remove?
No, we'll deal with it. Thanks anyway.
See ya.
See ya, thanks. So you're Mr. Morris?
Yeah. He must have fell down through the well.
Did either of you see him fall?
No.
No. I just opened my door and found him, that's all. So I called Mr. Morris.
Right. What's his name?
Pearson.
First name?
His sisters call him Edward. We just know him as Mr. Pearson.
And what are the names of his sisters?
They're Pearson as well. Anne and Claire. I don't think they ever got married. Not that it's any of my business.
Do his sisters live with him in his flat?
No, they're on the top floor. He lived on his own.
Yeah, well, that's understandable, isn't it? Who'd want to live with someone like him?
Are you going to tell his sisters? Only I didn't have the art to go up there.
Are they at home?
Oh, yeah, they'll be at home. I don't go out much.
Sierra Oscar from 469.
Go ahead, Polly.
Yeah, re your call to Perthshire House. It was a sudden death. Name of the deceased is Edward Pearson. Can you notify the duty officer and the FME?
Received.
What about the ground floor?
They're all out at work. Janet's in. Janet James and her kid.
Right, where are they?
On the first floor, and Mrs. Castle and Mr. Ebbs, they'll be at home. They're both on the second floor.
Right. You wouldn't happen to have an old sheet or a blanket, would you, Mrs. Rez?
What? Oh, yeah, of course. Just a minute.
I've checked his flat. Everything seems okay. Mm. What do you reckon, gal?
I'd say it was an accident. I'll go and see if I can have a word with the other residents.
Okay then. Will this do? Yeah, that'll be fine. Thank you. Mr. Pearson. I mean, was he sick at all? You know, unsteady on his feet?
No, not him. He was fit as a fiddle for his age.
Janet James?
Yes?
PC McCann, Sunhill.
Just a minute.
What's happening down there?
That's what I want.
And your name is?
Mrs. Castle, number 15.
Have either of you seen Mr. Pearson this morning?
No, but he was up and about just after 7:30, after the postman had been. I heard Ron talking to him.
Ron?
Mr. Ebbs.
Number 13. So what's wrong?
There's been an accident. Mr. Pearson's dead.
That's his flat there, sir. He lived alone. His name's Edward Pearson.
Are there any witnesses?
No, we haven't found anyone yet who actually saw him fall. But going by the NHS medical card in his flat, he's 68 years old. But apparently he was quite fit. He's got two sisters. They live on the top floor.
Oh, do they know about this?
No, not yet, sir.
Okay, probably wise to wait until we can tell them a little more.
But that's terrible.
Apparently it was an accident, Ron.
The poor man. What about his sisters? Have you told them?
Not yet. I'm waiting for the doctor to take a look at him.
Doctor? What's the point of a doctor taking a look at him if he's dead?
Mr. Ebbs, is it true that you spoke to him early this morning?
Yes.
What time was that?
About 7:45. I went down to put my milk bottle out. He was checking the post.
Which was none of his business anyway. He checked everyone's letters.
Did he speak to you?
Well, I said good morning, but he just nodded. I thought at first he was leaving one of his notes.
He left notes everywhere. Left them on the stairs for people, stuck notes on people's doors.
He complained a lot, you see. Sometimes he would argue with you, but most of the time he would leave notes. He was a very difficult man.
Bit of a climb, this one. No wonder they don't go out much.
Miss Pearson?
Yes?
I'm Inspector Monroe. This is WPC Page. Could we come in for a moment?
Come in?
If you wouldn't mind.
Oh. Hold on.
Who is it, Anne?
The police.
The police?
Thank you. It's about your brother. Bad news, I'm afraid. There's been an accident.
What do you mean, an accident?
Your brother's dead, Miss Pearson.
Dead?
Yes. It looks as though he had a fall.
Poor Edward.
Where did this happen?
Downstairs, in the basement.
Look, is there anyone who could be with you both? A friend or a neighbour?
Don't worry. We'll be all right. Here you are, Claire. Oh, dear, I suppose there'll be all sorts of things for us to sort out now. The funeral and that.
What floor did he live on?
Ground floor, Doctor.
Right, thanks.
We've been told that your brother seemed in good health. Was he?
Yes, he was.
Well, did he drink at all?
Drink?
Alcohol?
Edward, no. Never. Well, one glass of sweet sherry at Christmas, and that was his lot.
When did you last see him?
When was it?
I don't know. A couple of days ago. Tuesday, was it?
Yes, it could have been Tuesday.
And did he seem all right then?
Yes, he was his usual self. He was fine.
Do you think we ought to see him? Go down and see him?
Is that what you'd like to do?
I don't know.
You see, even though we live in the same building, we didn't spend much time together as a family. That's because Edward was never an easy person.
But he was still our brother.
Or perhaps it would be less distressing for you both if you waited until he's been moved to the mortuary.
Yes, all right. We'll do that.
Sir, FME's here.
Right. Well, as soon as it's finished, we'll get on to the coroner's officer to get the body moved. Perhaps you'd like to go with it, Gary.
I was going to tell you people earlier, but I didn't want to say nothing just now in front of Mrs. Rose. Otherwise, the whole neighbourhood would have heard about it by now.
So what do you want to tell us, Mr. Morris?
Pearson. I heard him having a bit of an argument this morning.
Who with?
I don't know who it was.
And what time was this?
About 8:30, something like that. I didn't take much notice because the old git was always arguing with someone or other.
Where were you at the time?
Down below. I just opened my front door.
And this argument, did it take place here on the ground floor?
No, it seemed like it was higher up than this. Up there somewhere.
Well, thanks, Mr. Morris.
Sir, FME would like a word.
Yes, Doctor.
The fall probably killed him. We'll know more after the post-mortem. But what I don't understand are those external lesions on the face and the upper part of the body. He must have hit something on the way down. Yet from the ground floor, it is a clear and uninterrupted drop. I'd say he probably fell from a greater height than the one suggested.
A bit serious, isn't it?
No, Mrs. Rose, it's just a precaution.
Yeah, well, I can see he's going to cause as much trouble dead as he did when he was alive.
He ended up down in the basement, so he either went over this rail here or one of them up there.
Right, take a look.
Well, I'll leave Polly here with you if you wish. She and Gary have already spoken to some of the residents.
That'll be a help, sir, thanks.
Excuse me.
Can I?
Oh, thank you. Do you know, this is the first time anyone's ever helped us up these stairs. He used to just stand there and watch me struggle. He'd even have a go at me if I left the pushchair there for 5 minutes.
I'm Detective Sergeant Daly. You are?
Janet James, number 9.
I take it Mr. Pearson wasn't one of your favourite people then, Janet?
No, he wasn't.
So how come he didn't unpack his shopping then?
Well, maybe he didn't need to. I mean, there's nothing perishable in there, just tin stuff, kitchen foil.
Which one of these residents heard the row this morning?
That's Mr. Morris, Sarge. He's downstairs, flat 2.
Excuse me.
Don't build them like this anymore, Kate. Mr. Yeah. Morris, D.S. Daly, can I have a word?
Come on.
The argument you heard this morning, Mr. Morris, you sure it wasn't on the ground floor?
Positive.
You don't happen to know why Mr. Pearson might have gone up to one of the other floors, do you? Did he have friends up there?
No. He wasn't the kind of person to have friends.
Well,
sometimes you go up there to have a moan or stick a note under someone's door. You're lucky, mate. If he was alive now, you'd have had one on your panda.
And you say the argument took place at 8:30 this morning?
Yeah.
I take it you didn't recognise the voice of the person he was arguing with?
No.
Do you know whether it was a male or female voice?
No. As I told your mates, I didn't take much notice at the time. Anyway, Pearson was doing most of the talking, as usual.
I believe you told the officer that you saw Mr. Pearson first thing this morning and that you spoke to him, is that right?
Yes.
Did you see him at all after that?
No.
What about hear him? Mrs. Castle?
No, I didn't hear him. Well, not after Ron spoke to him anyway. Why?
Well, we've been told that Mr. Pearson was heard having an argument with someone.
Ron said good morning to him and he didn't answer. I wouldn't exactly call that an argument, would you?
Yeah, well, this argument was about an hour later, outside on one of the upper floors.
Yes, well, it must have been a radio or something, because we didn't hear anything, did we, Ron?
Mr. Ebbs?
No. We didn't hear anything.
Do you know of anyone in the building who would have wanted to harm Mr. Pearson?
Do you want me to write you a list? Come on, Olive. You must have heard it. You don't miss a thing.
Heard what?
An argument upstairs this morning, round about 8:30.
No. Anyway, I had the washing machine going and the tumble dryer. I wouldn't have heard much.
That makes a change.
I wouldn't take too much notice of what he said if I was you.
Why?
Too much of that.
A row? What sort of row?
Between Mr. Pearson and someone. Out here.
When?
8:30 this morning.
No, I didn't hear anything.
Yeah, but you were in at that time, weren't you, Miss James?
Yes. Look, if you want to come in, then come in. But keep your voices down, please. I've just got my kid to sleep. And I'd just like to say that I'm not sorry about what happened to Mr. Pearson. I suppose I ought to be, but I'm not. I just don't want any trouble. It's hard enough, I think, to bring up a kid on my own.
How do you mean trouble?
I don't want to get involved, all right?
Involved in what?
Answering questions and that. I just want to get on with my own life. That's the way it is, isn't it?
The way what is?
Well, with some people, like my ex-partner, they go out of your life and you feel sad. Other people go and it don't mean a thing. You don't know them, so it don't really matter.
But you knew Mr. Pearson.
I knew him as a troublemaker, that's all.
Yeah, you're right. That's the way it is. Oh, just out of interest, where'd you do your shopping, Janet?
Around the corner, why?
Just wondered.
Problem is the sequence of events. Without witnesses, how do I know what happened? I could dust the whole staircase, but with so many people using the stairs, it wouldn't mean anything.
But you'd agree with the FME, it didn't just fall one floor.
Oh, yeah. Anyhow, I'll take a look up top.
Dead man's sisters, Polly. What were the names?
Anne and Claire.
Yes?
Afternoon. Are you Miss Anne Pearson or Claire?
I'm Claire.
Detective Sergeant Daly, Detective Constable Skase. We realise that this is a difficult time for you.
Yes, it is.
But could you spare us a few minutes?
Right.
don't know how you cope with all those stairs, Miss Pearson.
We get used to them.
There's nothing to worry about. You just get on with what you're supposed to be doing. We've been making a list of the people we need to telephone or write to.
It's a good idea.
Of course, there weren't that many people to tell, but we still feel they should know. So, how can we help you?
About your brother?
Yes.
We don't know for sure, but we've reason to believe that his fall may not have been accidental.
Not accidental? But surely it was.
But that's a terrible thing to suggest.
Can you think of anyone in Perthshire House who might have held a grudge against your brother?
I suppose everyone disliked him, in a way.
Yeah, but was there any one person in particular?
No. Well, people didn't get on with Edward because he wasn't the kind of man you could reason with.
He set his own rules in life.
And what about you? Did you also dislike him?
He was our brother, so we put up with him.
Did you see him very often?
Only when we had to.
Why is that?
He was a very demanding person, and he was very critical. But he wasn't as independent as he liked to make out.
Why?
Well, he expected us to do things for him. Sewing, ironing, cleaning, that sort of thing.
Anything, Kate?
Still nothing new.
Any obvious signs of a struggle having taken place?
Nope. All I can say is he probably fell from the second or first landing, maybe one of the staircases. You see, on each floor there's a support strut spanning the stairwell. Except here on the ground floor. Let me show you something. That strut there. Slightly buckled. He could have hit that on the way down.
Did you ever see Mr. Pearson go shopping?
How do I know? You're talking to the wrong person, mate. I don't spend my time nosing out, like a lot of other people around here.
What do you know about his sisters?
No chop the top?
Yeah.
Not a lot. They keep themselves to themselves. I don't think they come downstairs much. And you can understand why, can't you?
Why?
With a brother like that, they'd better off up there, out the way.
You reckon Pearson went shopping in his slippers?
I don't know. Maybe he changed into them whenever he brought that lot back. Or perhaps he had it delivered.
What's that?
Silver receipt. Right, where's the eggs? Where's the butter?
He probably put them in the fridge.
Yeah, there you go. It's a little bit faint, but you can see the date and time on it.
8 o'clock this morning.
Right. No eggs. No new pack of butter.
Can't make out the name, though.
Yeah. No, it's not very clear, is it?
Yeah, the supermarkets don't open till 9:30.
Doesn't have to be a supermarket, though.
Rod, what is this? 8 o'clock this morning. If he was doing his shopping, then somebody must have spotted him, and I'm pretty sure he wasn't mugged for a carton of eggs and half a pound of butter.
Excuse me. Come up here, please. In here.
Yes?
I want you to know from the start that this isn't my idea.
All right, Sylvia.
I also want you to know that Janet and me are staying here in this room with him.
Sylvia, please. This isn't my idea either, but it has to be done. Now let Ron say what he has to say.
What do you have to say, Mr. Ebbs?
Mr. Pearson.
What about Mr. Pearson?
I pushed him. I couldn't help it. I couldn't take any more.
It's all right, Ron. We're here with you.
He was always going at me about something. Yesterday, it was where I left my rubbish bag. Today, he comes upstairs banging on my door, telling me I'd left the security door off the latch again. So I did it. I pushed him. I pushed him hard. I pushed him down the stairs.
What time was this?
About 8:30.
Did you see him fall?
Fall?
Yeah, over the stair rail.
No, he staggered downstairs to the next landing. I saw him trying to get to his feet. He looked sort of shocked.
You say you saw him get to his feet?
He was trying to, yes. I saw him stagger and grab the rail, but I didn't see any more. I got scared and went back indoors. I never meant to hurt him. I never hurt nobody in my life.
And I take it you and Janet knew about this all the time?
Yes. It's your mate.
Excuse me a minute.
Found out where the shopping came from. There's a corner news agent serving early, and it wasn't Pearson who did his shopping at 8 o'clock this morning. Somebody else did it for him.
Who?
One of his sisters.
We've been waiting for you. We knew you'd be back eventually. Come on, Claire. Edward rang us early at 7, saying he wanted some shopping. As usual, he didn't ask. He just told us we had to get it. I bought what we needed in the same shop.
Eggs and butter?
Yeah. When I got back to Perthshire House, he was in one of his moods. Well, someone on the third floor hadn't bothered to collect his post for a couple of days, and Edward was threatening to send it back to the post office.
Had anything else annoyed him?
Yes. Mr. Ebbs had left the front door off the latch again, and that put Edward in a rage. In order to try and keep the peace, I took the letters up to the third floor and put them in the letterbox. But that wasn't all.
Tell us.
He was angry with Claire. She hadn't been down to do his ironing for a week or so. He said, when he'd finished with Mr. Epps, he was going up to sort her out once and for all. When I got to the third floor, I saw Claire waiting there. She heard what he said. She was so frightened. You see, he'd bullied us for years. Well, Claire more than me, because she's the youngest.
Then what did you do?
We heard Edward arguing and shouting with Mr. Ebbs. We crept down to the second floor and peered over the stair rail.
Did you see Mr. Ebbs push your brother?
Yes. He fell back down the stairs. I suddenly realised it'd be easy.
What? What would be easy?
I took Claire by the hand. We didn't say anything because we both knew what we had to do. We moved quickly down to the first floor.
Your brother saw you then?
Yes, he was hanging over the stair rail. He seemed shaken and stunned. And he looked up at us for help. We both grabbed him. We gave him one good shove.